Good morning, friends and fellow traders. This is Doug Campbell with Right Way Options, and this is the morning market preparation video for December 19th, 2018. So today is FOMC day. Today we're going to find out what the FOMC is going to do. Boy, I tell you, there's pressure on the FOMC from both sides. You know, folks from the Wall Street Journal and even Cramer have chimed in that the FOMC needs to back off on its rate increases. A lot of pressure there. Now, the Fed's funds future rates are suggesting that there's still about a 70%+ chance that they will follow through and go ahead and raise the interest rates by 25 basis points. So I'm kind of curious today, what do you think the Fed will do today? If you could leave that in the comments. So will they raise or will they not raise today? I would love to hear that in the comments below, what your thoughts on today's action will be. Now, when we take a look at that decision, there's an awful lot of energy focused in on that FOMC decision today. And when we as traders overly focus on those events, we can get ourselves kind of sideways in the market really easy in anticipation of probably some big moves today. So let's step back and realize that the most important thing is not what the FOMC does. It's how the market reacts to that news and how we as traders respond to that reaction. So kind of keep that in mind. Whatever they do is what they're going to do. There's nothing we can do to control that. And then we have to manage how that market reacts. So although there's all this pressure and anticipation built up, just remember, it's out of our hands. The best we can do is sit back, wait for the price action to move, follow along if we choose to do so, and decide how we're going to respond or react to that price movement. So with that, let's take a quick look at the Dow Jones average here. And by the way, please stick around. I do have a couple of things for you to watch today, maybe some watch list items to take a look at. So yesterday another volatile day where we whipped around considerably here. It looked like for a while we were going to move higher, then we slipped all the way back down almost and ended up bouncing around several times during the day in another whippy session. And this morning, as I'm recording this, we are currently up in the Dow futures 200 points. So another gap in the market. Now, what the market is responding to is there was a budget deal in Italy, kind of relieving some of the tensions over there. And that's allowed the European markets to rally. Asia markets were mixed overnight. But there's also the news that the White House may be softening a little bit on the border wall, and that they may be getting closer to an agreement. I don't know if that's true or not. It's just the market is kind of responding to some of these events. If we take a look right now, the futures are indicating this gap up into this area here. That is a good sign that we're seeing some follow through possibly to the upside. That was just a barely bullish hold of that low here in the diamond. So a push higher would be awesome. Let's keep in mind that if we push higher, we're going to have to watch this level right here for a price resistance. If we happen to fail today, and I got to tell you, a 200 point gap on a FOMC day, we could see an awful lot of whippiness in the market today. So be very, very careful how you trade this. If we were to gap up and then see sellers coming in, it could get pretty ugly today in a whipsaw type price action. So watch that carefully. Let's take a look at the SPY real quick. SPY, now kind of an interesting pattern here on the SPY. We missed it by a tick or two, but if you pay attention to candlestick patterns at all, this has the possibility of a kind of a tweezer bottom pattern. Those are typically bullish patterns, but remember, candlestick patterns are very short-term in nature. So Just because we have a tweezer, potential tweezer bottom, doesn't necessarily mean we will just, knock the ball off the cover and rip this market higher. Knock the cover off the ball, I should say. As you can see here, we're gapping up this morning pretty substantially, but we're still beneath this resistance level. So it's going to be really important that those bulls follow through and push us back up there. We need to get above there and hold a rally back up. Let's blow this up here just a little bit. A rally back up, or even this gap up open that fails here, could be pretty devastating for the market. So kind of keep that in mind. Also notice that we have pretty close to that tweezer bottom right here as well on the SPY. Any rally back above here and a hold above here would be a bullish sign that maybe the bulls are going to defend and hold on. So kind of keep that in mind as you plan your day. Let's take a look at the Qs. Now the Qs, boy, it's been a rough time for the Qs. And this morning there's bad news from Facebook, and that could affect the Nasdaq a little bit. And if we take a look right here, holding this level is a pretty good thing for us in the Qs. We need to hang on to there. So this gap up this morning is kind of giving us a little tiny bit of room above that support level. But if we happen to run into that price resistance, and you can see we have lots of different layers of price resistance in here, and pick up some selling that pushes us back down, we could be in real trouble here. Breaking of this support would likely send us down here into this support level. So keep an eye on that today. Hopefully we'll get some follow through buying today after this gap, and not just another intraday whipsaw. We gap one direction and then trade it all the way the other direction like we have been lately. Let's take a look at IWM. That poor IWM is a sickly son of a gun. And as you can see, this failure up here was fairly significant, failing below its trend line, failing at that price resistance. Let's pull this back a little bit so you can see that resistance level. So here's that price resistance level in the chart. And you can see as we failed that, we just immediately headed down to the next level of support, and we crushed right on through there. Now, this level of support, I base this off a weekly chart. So if you look at this, I tried to pick up an area where we got the most touches in here, but yesterday we were still unable to hold on to that. So it's possible the next layer of support in IWM is down here. So watch that closely. The small caps are really struggling bad here in this market. This morning you can see that they are indicating a gap up, but we're still significantly below this resistance point. So keep an eye on that. Let's take a look at the VIX. That VIX really put some nervous energy into the market yesterday. Even though we did catch a rally back up, notice that the VIX, the fear did not drop out of this market at all. As a matter of fact, it pushed up a little bit higher, closing above a 25 handle yesterday and threatening this resistance level where we might have that push through and breakout to, some nasty panic here in the market. Let's hope that doesn't occur. Let's hope this 200 point gap up this morning has enough energy in it that it starts to reduce that fear just a little bit, pull us back. We need to break down below this little uptrend here to start relieving some of that fear pressure. And then of course we have these support levels in here that we need to just really start breaking this down. So hopefully we can start resolving some of these unknown events in the market releasing some of this fear and calming the market down just a little bit. Only time will tell, and we'll have to wait and see. Let's take a look at T2122. T2122 yesterday was indicating we were right down here in the basement, right very, very close to zero, and a completely bullish reversal zone in the market. We can see this no matter how far back you go. We move the market down into this area, and you see we normally catch a bounce. So right in here, we're suggesting we're in that bullish reversal zone, and we have plenty of upside potential here in the market. So again, what I don't want to see is one of these big major spikes where we move several hundred points in a day. We need a little bit more of a calming effect, reduce some of the volatility, and have a nice steady move up out of here would be really nice to see. So we'll see if the FOMC can dance that line today effectively and calm the market. It's going to be interesting to see how the market reacts to that and what their actual decision is for the day. So let's take a look here at our economic calendar. We have a couple things to pay attention to here on that economic calendar today. We have existing home sales coming in at 10 o'clock and at 10:30, the EIA petroleum status report. And then the whole afternoon is going to be wrapped around that FOMC. 2 o'clock is the Fed announcement and Fed forecast, and then the 2:30 chairman's report, which could keep us choppy and very volatile in the market until after the Fed is finished reacting to the Fed to the FOMC press conference. So it could be a wild and woolly day. We're going to have to buckle up and be really, really careful today in our trading. So let's take a quick look at a couple things that we might want to keep an eye on. First, let's take a look at TLT. TLT is the Treasury bonds. Now, of course, Treasury bonds are going to react to anything that happens in interest rates. And if we take a look here, and I'm going to go to a weekly, as a matter of fact, we have been in a long-term downtrend here on Treasury bonds. But you can see here recently, our bonds have been rallying up pretty sharply. And I'm going to go back to a daily here. And on that daily chart, as you can see, we have built a nice little uptrend here going into this FOMC meeting. We're testing this downtrend line. As a matter of fact, we kind of peeked our head out of that downtrend line yesterday. So we're going to have to watch this closely. TLT, if they raise rates, TLT will likely see some kind of a response to that. A raising of rates, bond prices may suffer a little bit. If they don't raise rates, you know, to be honest, you don't know how the market's going to react. Anything is possible here. I shouldn't say this is what's going to happen, but TLT might be one to watch. If we do get a break of this really long-term downtrend and a hold in here as support in some place, TLT could have some major upside in it. So we want to keep an eye on TLT. Other stocks to maybe kind of keep an eye on, if you're looking for a short trade, UAL continues to look pretty good here as a short trade, and the possibility that it will trade down into this next level of support, you might want to keep an eye on that. This is a failure right in here at the 50-day moving average, which is a strong shorting pattern failure here. So watch for that potential move down on UAL. Keep an eye on it. If you're looking for a long trade, there are a few long trades out there that are looking pretty good. If you like if you're interested in gold, ABX. Now, remember, anything in gold could be negatively impacted by a rate in decision. So, or positively impacted by a rate decision. And you can see we had a nice Morningstar pattern pattern here produced yesterday, right here at the downtrend line on ABX. That's looking pretty good, but notice that we're gapping down this morning in gold. So who knows what's going to happen here, but there's a nice looking chart to kind of be aware of. Another gold stock that I mentioned yesterday to members, NEM looking really nice here, breaking through this bottoming pattern right in here, looking pretty decently and rallying in a nice trend up, nice bullish pattern here. We'll have to watch this. Now the next resistance level in this chart, of course, is right up here, so watch that closely. So, hey, with that, everyone, I want to wish you all a fantastic day, and I want to wish you great profits. And if this is the first time you've seen these videos, please do me a favor. Click that subscribe button on YouTube, follow me button on Facebook, click those thumbs up buttons, and drop those comments. You guys have just been awesome about leaving comments and clicking those thumbs up buttons. Thank you so much for doing that. I truly, truly appreciate it. And thank you for all those wonderful, supportive comments. You guys are awesome. Everyone, take care. Have an awesome, awesome day. And we'll talk to you all very soon, bright and early Thursday morning. Take care now.